Imagine drifting above the clouds, weightless, interrupted only by the sound of your breathing. This is Saanich Inlet. Join Dan St. Laurent and I, 130 feet below the surface, as we explore life among the clouds.
A primitive, living animal some 12 feet or more across, cloud sponges contain no true tissues or organs. Instead, a sponge is a group of loosely connected cells. It's supported by a skeletal structure made up of silica, like tiny splinters of glass. By creating a low-pressure flow of water through its tiny pores and out the volcanic-like top, the cloud sponge brings in oxygen, filters out microscopic planktons for food, while it removes carbon dioxides and wastes. Little is known about these sponges, however. Ongoing research suggests that they may live as long as 200 years. Resembling an apartment complex, cloud sponges are home to numerous crabs and shrimp. Many species of rockfish, including this striking juvenile yellow eye or red snapper, hides among the sponges, often living inside its tubes. The giant Pacific octopus leaves its den in search of food. It knows that red rock crabs often hide among the clouds. But the crab heads for cover, not wanting to end up as one more discarded shell that marks the entrance to the octopus den. While the octopus continues its hunt, we check our gauges and find that it's time to leave the clouds and head for the surface. But a drifting jellyfish, the cyania, or sea blubber, catches our eye and we swim over to investigate, being cautious to avoid the 30-foot-long stinging tentacles. Finally, we complete our ascent, having spent a brief moment drifting among the clouds.